2,800 miles, 8 states, 10 cities over the past 4 days with 2 people from my team. And it has me reminiscing about what we've done with the ABR Roadshow and what we're doing with americasbestrestaurants.com as a vision. I think it's important that all of us tell our story and let everybody know where we've been, where we're going, and why. Today, I want to talk about the last 3 years and our company.
My goal is to help restaurant owners finally get to where they want to go. But more than that, my goal is to find entrepreneurs within that segment that actually know what it means to hustle. That's my goal. Come on the journey with me.
Restaurant Marketing Secrets, episode 591. I'm your host, Matt Plapp, and today we go down memory lane because this week on the road, I got to tell the story about what we were doing more than normal. You see, we were taking our fourth van that we just purchased and putting it on the road in Colorado to replace our OG van, Obi-Wan Kenobi, our first ever roadshow van that I bought this month, 3 years ago, May of 2021. That really got me thinking about what we're doing, why we're doing it, where we've been. So as a brief overview of America's Best Restaurants, my vision, I guess it was 7, 8 years ago, was to create a media outlet dedicated to independent restaurants, a website that allowed independent restaurants to have a listing based on their accolades, to have no reviews from consumers, and to be able to control the narrative. And then underneath that, my goal was to create a series of shows. Shows not made for cable, because we all know that cable TV is done, but made for the little screen, your cell phone. And I've got this master plan of what we're going to do with multiple different series, but the main series was the ABR Roadshow. What if we bought a motorhome and we drove it around the country and we filmed at restaurants? That was the question many years ago. Well, in 2021, I realized that had we done that 3 years earlier like I planned, had I had the guts to pull the trigger on it, we could have maybe helped independent restaurants at a different level with what we would create on americasbestrestaurants.com. The question also on my team, what if we had a motorhome that we drove around the country, that different groups of us flew in, met the motorhome at restaurants, filmed a micro TV show built 100% for social media, and helped local restaurants tell their stories? Well, of course, I got comments back about a motorhome being hard to drive and your idea doesn't really sound scalable. And so then I kept tweaking it and tweaking it. Well, in May of 2021, I said, you know what? You're right. We all might not be able to drive a motorhome. Well, we can all drive a van. And Mercedes makes the Sprinter van because when we were a RV dealership, we sold them for Airstream. They're easy to drive. I know we can all drive them. Let's get it. So with a day's notice and bouncing it off a couple of my team, I went and bought our first Mercedes Sprinter van, which is actually sitting here as I speak with me in Las Vegas. Going to get some repairs done to it, going to get a new wrap, and it'll be our backup van for the West Coast. But the story of what we did with that was wild. So I knew that what we were going to do was going to work, but I had no proof, and I was not comfortable charging people for a product that I didn't really know how we were going to do it. In June of 2021, myself, David Schlatter, Austin Turner, Doug Smith, Luis Rivera, and my dad, Dwayne Plapp, hopped in the van, unwrapped, and drove up to Chicago, Illinois. We lined up a handful of restaurants to visit on the way up and the way back to test out what we thought the ABR Roadshow could be. We came back. We had a few weeks of meetings. David Schlatter, who at that time was my personal videographer, helped edit the episodes into a show format that we could wrap our heads around. And by July 5th, we were ready to film all over the place.
Break time. I need a huge favor. Go to theheroesofhospitality.com and check out our brand new docuseries for 2024. We're creating 8 episodes to chronicle the journey of our business. We're going to be traveling the country, telling your stories as it relates to growing your restaurant's marketing
And you're going to be able to see behind the curtain of what we're building, why we're building it, and how it will benefit the restaurant industry as a whole. Now, this is where it got fun. So July of 2021, I came up with a plan that we would start in Naples, Florida, and we would go all the way up into Georgia, then into South Carolina. We had a deal with Cisco, South Carolina, and North Carolina, where we would film at some of their restaurants over the course of 8 weeks. I want to say it was all of August and a little in September. And then at that point, we would head from there and go through West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, Indiana. We were going to work our way all the way up into Michigan, all those areas. We came up with 12 states that we thought, hey, if we can visit these 12 states over 12 months and film at 6 to 10 restaurants a day, 3 to 5 days a week, we'll make an impact and create a name, but more importantly, we'll help the restaurant industry and we'll figure out if this idea of the ABR Roadshow, a made-for-social-media TV show for the restaurants to air on their social media channel to be a very high-level marketing tactic, would actually be worth it. Well, the good news is we found out it was really worth it. The bad news was we found out that what we were doing was unscalable. The volume we were doing every day didn't allow us to tell the story. It didn't allow us to have the time with the owners. And at the same time, what we were doing for free, which you have to at some point to find product market fit, you have to see what people need, want, desire, could obviously not be done for free unless we sold this to another outlet, like a Netflix, unless we had sponsors like, you know, Coca-Cola, unless we had a media company backing us that was going to own and control the rights to it and air it on their channel and sell advertising. Well, none of that was going to happen on my watch. I wanted this to air on the Facebook pages of the restaurants we were filming at. I wanted no sponsorship in it. I wanted no commercials, and I wanted to control the narrative because that's what's important. The other aspect we realized was the marketing power that could be behind these episodes was unbelievable. You see, when we started doing this in 2021, we would just give the restaurants guidance. Hey, we're coming to your restaurant. If we were you, 5 days before we would do this, 2 days before we would do this, the day of we would do this, and then a month later when your episode airs, here's how it goes down. Well, a lot of you didn't listen, and I get it because you're not marketing people. So in February of 2022, we looked at the numbers and said, okay, we've spent $500,000 so far. We've got approximately another $500,000 we can spend the next 12 months. How can we offset that and do what we want to do? So we started charging a small fee. And the goal of the small fee was just to make sure we didn't lose too much money too quickly. And that has evolved over time to where now the company is profitable, not crazy profitable, but profitable enough to use the revenue coming in to fund our growth. And that's always been the goal. How do I create a brand that consumers know, like, and trust, that restaurants can be affiliated with? And then how can we create elevated marketing products? Now, along this journey, some of the cool things that I love to tell people that I want people to understand is we had three of us that were hosts for most of that time early on. Myself, Doug, and Luis. Doug and Luis would do every other week. I would pop in there about every third week. Then we had two camera guys, Austin and Ryan, both trained by David the first 2 months. But then after August, September, were on their own. They were full-time camera guys on the team. But every other week, because one of them was on the road at a time, the other one would be setting up the visits for 2 weeks from then. Luis and Doug were also on my sales and marketing consulting team. So they had full-time jobs with the company as well as being on the road every couple weeks. And then you had David Schlatter, who is now our marketing director. Back then was a pseudo marketing director, creative and post director for the TV show, and then also my personal videographer and in charge of marketing me. So none of us were doing one thing. It's kind of like you as a restaurant owner, which I figured you'd appreciate. You're juggling a lot of balls. And it was in 2022 that we realized we had to bring on some full-time staff dedicated to logistics, distribution, all the fun stuff behind the scenes of the roadshow. Because up to that point, a few people, you know, David, Ryan, and Austin, in their off weeks of not being on the road, were not only coordinating all of the next couple weeks' visits, which at that time was 25 to 30 a week, but also the footage getting off the road, getting to the editors, getting edited, getting published. It was a big task. Oh, and by the way, there's hotels and airfare for multiple people flying every week. Doug coordinated most of that on top of his other job of, you know, running our sales department and, oh, by the way, on the road every couple weeks being the host. So in early 2022, we decided, okay, we had to invest in this product more than we thought. And that's when we started getting some skin in the game from the restaurants and charging a small fee in exchange for the production aspect of it. That summer, we went on to hire an account manager. We went on to hire a professional host. We went on to buy better equipment. And over the next 2 years, it became a really special product and what it is today. Now we have 29 full-time people dedicated to the ABR Roadshow. 29, up from 4 the summer of 2022. We have a professionally trained creative director, Joel, who moved to Kentucky from Brooklyn, where he worked for the History Channel. We have editing in-house now, not overseas. They did a great job overseas, but you got to be able to look over the shoulder and make some team decisions. So we brought that in-house. There are 5 full-time editors, including one of our guys, Max, who's in charge of what we call post-production, overseeing the product. There are multiple account managers. There's a PR specialist. There is everything you can imagine to make this thing happen. And now we have 2 vans, one on the East Coast, one on the West Coast, that both serve the states pretty equally. We hit 48 of the main states here. We haven't hit Hawaii or Alaska yet. That's in the game plan. Everybody keeps asking me. They all want that week for their vacation. But those 2 vans rotate from basically the East Coast to the Midwest and the West Coast to the Midwest. They overlap a little. There's a backup van now as I speak in Las Vegas. We have our backup van in Northern Kentucky. We have our headquarters where most of our people are in Northern Kentucky. And we have multiple award-winning hosts for America's Best Restaurants, the ABR Roadshow. We have multiple professionally trained videographers. We've got creative departments. It has really evolved into something special. As I'm doing this podcast, we have filmed at approximately 1,500 restaurants in 3 years. To put that in perspective with regards to the volume, the biggest name cable TV food show that you all know about in 15 or so years has done about a third of what we've done in 3 years. The volume we are producing right now, nobody else is doing anything close to that level of organic, natural storytelling content on the internet. And it's all around independent restaurants. We're doing 4 episodes a day, Monday through Friday on average. The goal for 2025 is 1,000 episodes, a 51-week schedule, both vans running full force. These episodes are making a huge impact. I just heard back from one of the restaurants the other day that his sales are up 30% since we visited. His social media reach, impressions, engagements are up 25%, and his episode hasn't even aired yet. That's just from the pre-episode filming, marketing, and the live videos we did on site to talk about what we were doing. When his episodes hit, it'll give him even more traction. And that was always my big picture. But when I tell this story, it just brings back so many memories. Today, as I'm heading back to Las Vegas, I'm in the back of the van for the first time in probably 2 years, laying back there, laptop, some coffee, looking out the window, looking at the mountains. And I'm thinking about where this was 3 years earlier. It was an idea of taking a motorhome around and telling your stories and creating a social media marketing opportunity like no other for independent restaurants. It's been an amazing journey. And we wouldn't be here without the amazing employees that have been ride or die that have gone way over and above and beyond what they were expected to do. And they've helped us build a foundation, because what's next is continuing the ABR Roadshow. The goal for 2025 and on is a stable 1,000 episodes a year, 500 per van, featuring independent restaurants in every state. And then above that, we're going to create other shows. Other shows that will be on bigger screens, Netflix and Hulu, that'll be more one-off, larger-scale productions meant to get name recognition out there for America's Best Restaurants, so consumers decide to go look at what America's Best Restaurants is, and then they find your restaurant. And then they find America's Best Restaurants, you know, ABR Roadshow episodes, and they find the ABR Rewards Program we're building. They find the ABR Shirt and Sauce Squad that we're building for consumers to get your sauces and rubs and shirts in their hands from all over the country. Our goal is to create a place where you control the narrative and where you win and you get an opportunity to get an upper hand on the big brands. My friends, I hope you enjoyed it. I love telling that story. I hadn't told it in a long time. Are you telling your story? Is it on your social media? Are you doing podcasts like this? If you're not, I hope you'll take my advice and start doing it. Because what you've done with your restaurants, and I found this out over thousands of conversations, what you've done in your restaurants is nothing short of a miracle. Your teams, yourself, your spouse, your family, your friends have all done something very special for your community. And it's about time we tell that story. Talk to you tomorrow.
So as you know, I don't charge for my content. We don't have sponsors. We don't have product placement in here. But what I want your help with is spreading the word. If you're finding value here, do me a favor. Share this on your social media. Share an episode with something that made sense to you, that's relevant to your restaurant, that you got value from, and tag Matt Plapp and America's Best Restaurants. Also, go to America's Best Restaurants on Facebook and on Google and leave us a review. Let us know the impact we've had on your restaurant with our roadshow, with our marketing help, or with our podcast. And last but not least, if you want to take the next step and help me out a lot and help us out a lot, text me a testimonial, 859-743-2408. That's my cell. A selfie video would be awesome about the impact this content or our company is having on your independent restaurant. But worst case scenario, just a few kind words. The way we can help lift this industry up is to help get content like this to more independent restaurant owners. And you are the key to spreading the word. I appreciate your support. Have an amazing day.